best I described it, is ballistics equipment for American SWAT team, tactical operation. The SWAT team, it's a 23 person SWAT team, and I guess the best way to describe that is if they don't, if you don't hear about them coming, that's a good thing. There's a couple of vendors in here we could use, because as the agenda references, the bulk of this cost is helmets, ballistic panels, and body armor type stuff. And why do we need to replace that? I think everybody knows that that stuff expires after a certain period of time, including the helmets. Inside the helmets, but that the SWAT team members wear, they have ballistic kevlar inside those things too. Even the shields, things of that nature too. Currently, our equipment's expired. One of the concerns we had last year when I was talking with Mark and Chuck was that I don't want us to get in trouble with OSHA about violating any of the procedures on this equipment because of the new deal. I do want to mention a couple of things. This is clearly a Homeland Security thing. So some of y'all may ask, well, why not try to get funding from the Homeland Security? Does that exist anymore? It's right. In fact, like the command truck we have, we initially got it. There's just no more money up there. Even Gina Area 2, that's our area down here, that provides that we used to meet regularly, and there's funding coming through from Washington, D.C., that money's gone. It's right up. So we have a couple of choices. There's a tall grid. Greg found us a couple of vendors. You notice there's only two there that provides some ballistic equipment. If you approve the lowest bid, which would be Smyrna, at least this year's, then we'll get the equipment in. What do we do with the old stuff? We have a company that will take the old Kevlar, even once expired, and then short it, so it doesn't get into the hands of somebody else. That's all we can. Any questions?
Question. All right. Did that take to you? This helped us. Do we get it in front?
No, sir. We don't. The Kevlar, we don't, because it's difficult to dispose of that stuff anymore. But they will dispose of it and send us a letter back. It's really a decent level of
problem. Recycling?
I don't know what they do with it, but they have to short dispose of it. And when I thought it was supposed to, they mind it, punch it up, and they have to send us a letter back, which we maintain on file, and send the department just to show that the Kevlar can dispose of it. So keep in mind, all this stuff's expired. And now we do have a grant that we get every year that pays 50% of the vest for the officers. But that grant's completely different from this stuff. This stuff is expensive. Then you're talking about ballistics. Equipment assault rifles.
And this lasts for 5 years.
They'll last for 5 years, generally. The helmets will be a little longer, Council. They have a longer lifespan, but currently, your SWAT team is wearing equipment that's expired. And that's all we're here. This was approved in the event last year, but.
Yeah. Any other questions?
Five years of last year.
5 years for the actual vest, but the helmets will last a little longer. And the shields that you see that carry and stuff like that. Yeah. Great question.
Any other questions?
How many officers does this
cover? There are 23 officers.
So, yeah, I make a motion that we approve the $75,000 to $35,000. We have a motion for a second. Is there any further discussion? All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, the same sign. There is none. All right, next item on the agenda.